We're all faced with hard decisions throughout our life. Knowing how to approach them and feel good about the decisions we make is a huge relief and time saver. By the end of this video, you will have an approach that you can use for both life and work decisions. So join me in 5 seconds. Hey everyone, my name is Johan Peterson and I'm a senior director in the video games industry. This means I regularly have to take really hard decisions that I know I have to live with. To me, this was one of the hardest, most difficult things when I got into a director role. You're suddenly the one that's taking the decisions instead of the one that's advising them. All of a sudden, you're expected to take these really tough decisions without anyone above to consult. Like anyone else, I'm also facing big decisions in my life every so often. Today, I'll talk a little bit about how I approach decisions and how I do my best not to regret them later. I'm hoping this will give you a shortcut to becoming really comfortable taking decisions that you won't regret later, both in life and at work. So in this video, we will talk about 3 things. What to do before taking the decision, and what to do after taking your decision. Before we dive in though, take a second to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my future videos that will keep adding value to your life and your career. Do your homework. Before you take any decision, you want to make sure you do your homework. By going through these steps, you will know that you've done everything you can to take the best possible decision. A decision that you won't regret in the future. Set aside time. You'll want to give yourself some time to get to a decision, even though your time may be limited. And making a good decision will save you time in the future. For any small decision, book yourself 30 minutes to think. For bigger decisions, you'll need more time. And I recommend you divide it over several days so you can sleep on your decision. Having time blocked off for the decision will prevent you from feeling anxious about it. Define the decision. Any decision you make will have a chain reaction. To fully recognize the power behind each decision, sit down and try to define it. Get clear on the nature of the choice. If you are taking a decision to change something at work, it will definitely affect the people. It could potentially also affect the culture. On a personal side, if you're deciding between 2 jobs, it will likely affect things like salary, commute, benefits, pressure, and so on. So make sure you list the different options, or at least the ones you can think of. Then define the key factors that will be affected by your decision. Dig into the pros and cons and what excites you about the different options. Use your whole brain. When you weigh options for a big decision, you want to use both sides of your brain, not just the logical left side. The right side, our emotional intelligence, or EQ, is linked to our behavior. If you don't weigh this in, the part of your brain called nucleus accumbens won't activate. This means that dopamine won't get released into your body and you will remain in your comfort zone. And big decisions we don't want to take from our comfort zone. Oh, and by the way, please hit that like button to release dopamine into my body. Measure against your values. Always stop and measure your decisions against your personal core values. Taking a decision that goes against your values will not feel good and can cause you a lot of grief. Get coaching. Don't ask other people what to do. It will likely add even more confusion to the decision you're about to make. Talking to a great coach can help though, as he or she can help guide you to taking the decision yourself. This is especially great for people who are verbal processors. There is one exception to this rule that I can think of right now, and that's asking people who will be affected by your decision to weigh in. When it comes to your life decisions though, only you will know what's best for you and what will make you happy in the long run. Test scenarios. In certain cases, you can even test your decision before you take it. This allows you to expose yourself to new experiences, and that may help tilt you one way or another. Taking a decision. When you've done your homework and gone through all the previous steps, it's time to take a decision. Since you already weighed your options at this point, this will absolutely help you take a decision that will not make you feel regretful, even if it pans out to be the wrong decision. at a later date. You took the best decision to your knowledge at that point in time. Go with your gut. So when it's time to take that decision, you go with your gut. Your intuition is one of the most powerful decision-making tools. And it's based on your experiences, your education, your beliefs, and your hopes. To hone in on your gut feeling, take a moment to reflect on the things that got you to this point. How do you feel inside when you weigh the different options? Is there a knot in your stomach or your chest? Or lightness in your heart? Do you feel excited or happy? Tune into this inner wisdom and take your decision. There are a few things to consider as you've taken a decision. The first one is mainly for work decisions. Communication plan. Bigger decisions that you take at work requires a communication plan. This means you will have to carefully craft a document on how you will communicate this out to any people directly or indirectly impacted by the decision. You may need to have different versions for different groups of people. Also think through and document any questions you feel that you may get as a result of this, so you can answer them confidently. When you go wrong, you will take the wrong decision ever so often. The important thing here is that you don't judge yourself for taking the wrong decision or making the wrong choice. You need to learn from your mistakes, understand where you went wrong and how you can prevent it in the future. Adapt and add to your experience. And this is how we all truly grow, by failing. And this is why when you take a decision based on the steps in this video, you won't regret your decision, because even if it's wrong, you have learned something, you have grown. You took the decision to the best of your knowledge. Life is full of hard choices for everyone. By taking this approach though, your decision won't be anxiety-induced time drains. With the approach outlined in this video, you will have a strong foundation for any decision you have to take. The more decisions you take this way, the more confident you will feel every time. You will also learn from your wrong decisions. Understand why, adapt, and add to your knowledge. And this will improve your gut feeling over time. I drop videos every Tuesday, so check back next week. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.